Dr. Bilo, here we are.
Yeah. In front of a wonderful old farmhouse. And we're actually meeting Susanne Goscioni. She is soon to be Dr. Goscioni, works at the University in Luzern, is busy with her PhD about bionic implementations of facade, but she's actually an expert for facades. And today she will talk about the basics of windows and facades as a whole. And we will use this old farmhouse as the example.
Yes, here we go.
That's perfect. Thanks.
All right, so Susanne, today we talk about facade principles. That's a very basic one. Then the general performance of a building envelope, that's what we need to talk about. And then our strategies of how we solve this, which is the three lines of defenses. So, Susanne, understanding the idea of the building envelope, what is the building envelope about?
Well, the building envelope is an interface and it has a lot of tasks to fulfill. One is it's enclosing the inner environment from the exterior environment. It's protecting us from climate, but also it protects our inner climate. And it is, which is not least important, it is the aesthetic appearance. It is an image carrier. Carries our, let's say, our fashion. It's an image.
Okay, get it. Get it as a system. General performances, when we say, look at this, a number of bullet points, what a facade has to fulfill, define it.
Quite many. One is climate protection. That includes thermal protection, so that we don't lose our thermal, let's say, comfort situation. It protects us from the weather condition. This is one hand. It is responsible for ventilation, so for fresh air intake, as you can see here.
Okay, the windows, yeah.
Exactly, typical example. It's also, again with windows, responsible for enough daylight to come in and view to the outside. So this is the interface function, so the regulation between the interior and the exterior conditions. And what it also does on the structural side, it's responsible to or you have to take care of the dead loads and the payloads.
Okay, clear. And for education purposes, how would you define these general performances? How would you organize these performances?
I would say there are generally seen three levels or layers which a facade has to fulfill. The outer layer is the weather protective layer. That is responsible to protect us from water income and also too much wind and so on. Then in the middle you have the so-called insulation layer, which is responsible to keep this thermal protection, what I told before. And then to the inside, you have this inner layer, which is in massive construction. It's a plaster in modern system. It's a vapor barrier. So that is responsible for airtightness and water diffusion control. So we have three different layers with three different tasks, and it depends on the topology of the facade, if they are kind of merged in one construction or like in this classic facade systems, they are layered one after the other.
So when you look at this, this is the outer layer. It's a shingle setup. And then you would expect there's some kind of cavity or something behind. And then there comes this solid part, which is taking the loads, the functions, the insulation. And then there comes the inner part, which actually seals the building.
Exactly. It seals the building because we also have climate conditions from the inside that should not cause problems or damages to the facade construction. So you have to protect the transfer from the inner to the construction. And this is the outer protection. And that's a very nice example, this wooden shingles, because it's a very special, let's say, design in the way you construct or you prepare, you produce it. And that is responsible for water protection for sure. And because it's wood, it's a living material, it needs a cavity, air cavity behind, that it doesn't get rotten and works for a long life period.
Okay, and if I would peel it off, which I'm not going to do because it's such a nice building, how does this shingle setup work?
So the shingles are a bit longer than this, what you can see. Mm-hmm. They're about, it depends a bit on the type, but it's 15, 10, 17 centimeters high. And they are overlapping it. So they nail it to an under construction. It's like a horizontal wood
substructure
where you nail it on. You have to nail shingles because with screws you would destroy the function of the wood fibers. So you nail it, and then what you have to take care, which you don't see here, is really that these gaps between the overlaps, they really depend on the topology of the shingle, that it works. So the water runs down here on the front. It might go in a little bit, but because of this overlaying, it doesn't go in too much.
So they're actually layered, like one hand on the other hand, on the next, exactly. On the next.
So it's an overlapping, and behind you have an air gap. So ventilation comes from the bottom up, goes up, and takes off the moisture. Because this is a living material, it takes on moisture, which is good because it's regulating a little bit. But you also have to take care that it doesn't get wet and rotten later on. So you need the air gap, and that's called cold facade system, so-called. In that case.
Well, that's the next video. Thanks for this.
You're welcome.
Let's see if you find part where shingles are broken, which we may can peel off a bit.
Yes, let's do that.
Test 1.
Hallo, hörst du mich?
Susanne 2.
Kamera 2 läuft. Kamera 3 läuft auch.
Okay, Susanne, this is a nice place of a real old shingle facade. And it's actually nice to see how it's really working. Explain us.
Okay, what you can see, it's like a skin, it's like a dress. It's the outer dress of this construction. You can see here the wooden shingles, they're coming off now. They're at the end of their lifetime. But what is very nice, you can see here the nails. So they are nailed on a sub-construction on the counter battens. And
but they're actually nailed at the upper part. They're actually nailed at the upper part so that, say, the nails are penetrating these shingles, not in the area where they're exposed to the outside. And what we also can see easily is, say, this is one shingle, and then there's the next one, then there's the next one, there's the next one. There's maybe a layer of, what, 2-3 layers of shingles?
Really depends. When you go down here, you see more layers because this is the starting point. That's where the water comes over the edge, let's say, and it shouldn't run inside. So the layering is depending where you start. So the starting is the lowest, and then it's overlapping 3 times, so-called. And then usually it's really with this shingle, it's 2-3 centimeters overlapping or gap, and then the next one. So it really, the decision is made by the overlapping. How much are overlapping. So here it's 3 times. But that depends really on the type of shingle, so it differs.
What can you say about lifetime of that facade?
Depends also a bit on the wood. So oak wood, for example, is very durable, or larch wood is very durable. And they can, I don't know this age of this construction, but they could be up to 80, even 100 years old. Depends a bit on the wood and also on the site. If this is the weather site, so it's very exposed to lots of winds and haze and so on, it's a bit shorter. But it's a really long type material, longer than some modern materials.
Thank you for this comment. So this is the outer rain layer, and then as we described it earlier in this video, the inner part is a solid structure which takes the loads and is the insulation, and then the inner plaster does the vapor barrier.
Exactly. Okay. And maybe you must, it, even shingles are existing since about 6,000 years, so they're really old, and formerly they didn't have insulation. They use the air gap in between, and then the construction inside with some, I don't know, wool or some organic material to have a little bit of insulation. So the system lasts, is already very well established.
A raincoat.
Exactly, okay. As a raincoat.
Thanks.
I don't want to interrupt you, but we have to go. Next set is already prepared, so thanks.
Thanks.
Thank you very much for coming.
Okay.
It is a nice place to be.
Thanks for showing this.
Pleasure to meet you. Bye.
Thanks. Bye. All the best.